Hey, what's up Blender users, I'm Jonathan, and in today's video, we're gonna take a look at how to create water splashes using Mantaflow in Blender 2.82. This tutorial is gonna be narrated a bit quicker, just because I wanted to stay under 10 minutes. And by the way, if you enjoy my content, consider subscribing to my channel, because I upload a new video every Saturday. And with all that said and done, let's get straight into the video. We will first start by modeling our little scene, so delete everything, and to make our simulation pretty small, I'm gonna add in a cylinder as our collision guide and scale it to around this shape, and then go into edit mode, press 3 for face select, extrude this face and scale it down and extrude it downwards so you get a shape like this. We can now use this shape as our collision effector, and to make it a bit nicer to look at, let's shade it smooth, go into the object data properties panel and under normals check auto smooth. Now we're gonna again go into edit mode, select this face right here, and hit Shift D to duplicate it, press P and separate it by selection. So you get this face separated, just like that. We can now just go into edit mode again, extrude it upwards to our liking, and re-enable our default cylinder back. I also want to scale this mesh down right here and move it up a bit. And we can also scale it just like that. To keep everything nice and tidy, let's go to Object, Set Origin, and Origin to Geometry, just like that. The next thing would be our domain. I want this domain to be relatively small, so scale it up a bit, and then scale it on the Z-axis, till you have something that looks like this. For now, I'm gonna stay in the wireframe mode, and apply all the correct physics. So, for the domain, select Fluid, Domain, and Liquid. And for this cylinder, select Effector, and keep it at collision. And for this object, we're gonna select flow, liquid, and geometry. I'm also gonna turn up the sampling substeps, just for a nicer simulation. Okay, we can now, in Mantaflow, either test bake our simulation, or under the cache type, we can also select replay. But I found that the replay cache mode sometimes gives weird results. So, if we now play this animation, we can see our fluid just falling inside the cylinder, which is of course what we want, but we want our water splash. If you have a look at companies like ActionVFX, they actually generate water splashes by shooting real pistols into puddles, but we're not gonna use a projectile which flies onto the surface, but we're gonna use this sphere to push our fluid from the bottom to the top. So, add in a sphere, scale it down, and on the, for example, 5th frame, add in a location keyframe. Then we're going to go some frames forward, for example to frame 8, and move it upwards just like that. Maybe not that far, and give it another location keyframe. Now one frame further and move it outside of the domain and give it another keyframe. So we get this motion. This should now push our fluid upwards. So free and bake the data again. Of course, this now does nothing because we haven't specified it as a collision effector. So do that, and we can also turn up the sampling substeps for this effector, and then we can rebake again. Okay, as you can now see, we can generate a little water splash, and this is gonna be more noticeable once we turn up the resolution divisions. So let's just do that. For the thumbnail, I used a resolution division of 256, so let's just bake that. Okay, I only baked a few frames, but you can start to see our water splash right here. I didn't change any of the parameters, but certainly our splash is much bigger with the higher resolution divisions. Okay, but I think we can work with that. So let's scroll down on this panel right here and enable all the particles right here. Spray, foam, and bubbles. And we can also bake these. These standard parameters work fine just for this kind of simulation. Once those are baked, we can go to Mesh, Enable Mesh, and choose a particle radius for 1. So we just have a finer fluid around all these small particles right here. And also enable speed vectors. This will help us with motion blur later on. And hit bake mesh. Okay, we are now also done baking the mesh, and we can select it, and under the particle settings, we can disable the liquid particles right here. So we only see the particles which are gonna be rendered later. For the particles, let's add an anisosphere and turn down the subdivisions to 1, and we can just move it to the side for now. I'm also going to press M, make it a new collection, and call it part for particles. If we just take a look at our particles, we can see that they sometimes look like they're in a grid. This is just a bug in Mantaflow and will hopefully be fixed soon. But for now, we're going to first scale down the icosphere to 0.1 and after that, duplicate it a few times, go into edit mode and move it to a side, away from its origin, so we get some variation in this grid pattern. We will also assign a new material for all of these, so select one, press new, Ctrl L and select materials. So now they all share the same material and we're gonna just use a simple glass shader with an IR of 1.333 and the roughness set to 1. This gives me the best results. We can now select our fluid mesh, go into the particle settings and under render select collection, part and pick random. And do this for every particle system. So now we have all the particles assigned and we can hide all these unnecessary parts of our simulation. Just like that. We can also select our mesh, press W and shade smooth. And I think that looks really good. We can now place our camera in the scene and set up all our render parameters. That means I'm gonna go into cycles, GPU and under performance set the tile size to 256 because I'm rendering on a GPU. And under film, select transparent and transparent glass. This will make the glass shader transparent, which we're gonna assign right now. So hit new, glass, give it a roughness of 0 and an IOR of 1.333. And if we take a look at this in rendered mode, we can see that the glass is fully transparent. For correct lighting, we're gonna use an environment texture. And I'm just gonna choose this one with a nice overcast sky. So we get this result right here. In the passes panel, I also want to enable denoising data and vector. This is gonna help us later on in the compositing tab. So now we can render our frame. Okay, now that our frame is rendered, we want to enable motion blur. Okay, to do that, we're gonna go into the compositing tab, hit use nodes, and firstly add in the denoise node. We can then plug the noisy image output into the image input and do the same for the normal and albedo output. Just like that. And with node wrangler enabled, we can control shift click on the denoise node and denoise our image. For the motion blur, we're gonna use a vector blur node and then plug the image output to the image input, the depth to the Z input and the vector to the vector input. And for now, I'm gonna preview this with the undenoised image and again, hit Ctrl Shift Click. You can see that this kinda gives a cool result, but not a result we want, because the blur is way too high, so I'm gonna set it to 0.1. And I'm also gonna adjust the maximum speed value to 256. Okay, this now gives us a nice motion blur on the particles and the fluid. And this is essentially it. This is how you create water splashes in Mantaflow. You can of course make these particles brighter by just giving them a diffuse shader, but this is all to your liking. I hope you found this tutorial helpful, and if you did, consider liking and subscribing, and we're gonna see us in the next video next Saturday.